Brian, what's the matter? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why do you ask?
Because your message said you were in danger, so I dropped everything and came right here.
Oh, well, I thought it would be fun for all of us to come here and watch our Thanksgiving special.
What? I just left my wife and my brand new baby at the hospital on Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Jack, is Brian okay? I got a text. There is no emergency, is there, Brian? Oh.
Well, I just wanted to get everyone here quickly, so I used action phrases.
You mean phrases like, help, Lauren, please come, I'm bleeding profusely?
Yes, I correctly thought that that might get you to come to the studio quickly.
The studio that we're on vacation from because of Thanksgiving.
Yes, now is the perfect time to watch the BS of A Pumpernickel Boulevard Thanksgiving special.
Why don't we watch that at home with our families?
We're family.
So family, like people you don't have to pay to maintain a relationship with.
Brian, I'm here! Oh, so you're not trapped under that giant lemon anymore.
He never was.
What? No. He's here. Well, how else did he send me this picture?
Well, it's a new app called I'm Trapped Under a Giant Lemon. You see, you upload a photo of yourself, and it makes you look like you're trapped.
We get it, Brian!
I knew that lemon looked too big to be real.
All right.
Look. Since we're all here, we can either watch the BS of A Pumpernickel Boulevard Thanksgiving special or go home to our families. So what's it gonna be?
Yep. Take
family.
Care.
Anyway.
No one needs me, so.
The door's bolted.
Son of a...
ABC's 1+1. Learning's great. Learning's fun.
Fun.
Great times and diversity. We're all the same, you and me.
Yay!
Feeling good. Having fun. Everybody's number one. Eating vegan, living green. We don't keep score, that would be mean. Pumpernickel Boulevard. Pumpernickel Boulevard. Pumpernickel Boulevard. Pumpernickel Boulevard.
The BSFA presents The Pumpernickel Boulevard Thanksgiving Special, starring America's felt sweetheart, Hoodie the Puppet. Also starring the internet's 15th most famous political comedy host, Brian Sack.
Hey there, Hoodie. I see you're taking down your Halloween decorations.
Yeah, Halloween's over. It's time for the next big holiday. Here, hold that. Voila!
A Christmas tree.
Yes, Feliz Navidad, as they say in Cuban.
Christmas? It's 2 days after Halloween, Hoodie. Aren't you forgetting something?
I know. I'll get the cheap Chinese ornaments at Target.
No, Hoodie. I mean, aren't you forgetting that there's a holiday that comes before Christmas?
Oh, yeah, but you know, Hanukkah is all over the place. You'd think that the chosen people could choose a date, you know, and stick with it.
No, Hoodie.
Kwanzaa?
No, a real holiday.
Oh, Ramadan.
No, Hoodie, I'm talking about Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving? Who cares? The stores are already playing Here Comes Santa Claus.
The stores are... Santa? In the middle of November? Hoodie, would you like to hear a Thanksgiving song?
Okay.
Great. Here's one my mom used to sing. Sitting at your table with your whole family.
Huh.
Time for talking, time for fun, and time for roast turkey.
Hey, guys!
Oh, hey, Tom. Brian was just singing a song about Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it sounded great. Your family ate what?
That was it. It's just nothing.
Oh, come on, sing it again. It was great.
No.
It sounded awesome. I want to hear it again.
No, I don't want to keep you, really.
Please, I have all the time in the world. Sing it! Look me in the eyes and sing it!
Sitting at the table with your whole family. Time for talking, time for fun, and time for roast turnips.
Turnips. Weird. Gobble, gobble. Doesn't even rhyme.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hey. Brian's singing a song about roast
turnips. Oh, I tell you what. Maybe there's a holiday song that you like to sing, Tom Turkey.
Gobble, gobble. We sing this one every year. Where is mommy? Where is mommy? Where's my dad? Where's my dad? All my friends are missing. All my friends are missing. I feel sad. I feel sad. Gobble, gobble! Awkward.
Pumpernickel Boulevard! Yeah.
Delicious feast! I can tell this is the beginning of an enduring friendship between the Native American and the white man.
Could be.
Right?
Yeah, it's good so far. Hey, John. What did you and your wife dress as for Halloween?
I went as a subsistence farmer and she went as a witch.
Huh.
Then I burned her alive at the stake.
You never can be too careful.
No, I'm not immune to smallpox. Why?
No reason. Pilgrim Fathers.
I don't know about you guys, but this is making me really hungry for Thanksgiving dinner. Roast turkey, gravy, cranberry jelly, wine, turkey, wine, stuffing, wine, gravy, wine, wine sauce, wineberry jelly, roast wine.
Brian, you realize that makes it sound like you have a problem.
What kind of wine, Loom?
Never mind.
I think I forgot to turn my oven off. Can I go back home and turn off my oven?
Relax, wine. Your oven will still be on when you get home.
Did I mention that my wife just had a baby a few hours ago and that I left her at the hospital to come here because you lied to me? Honey, no. I love you. I'm so sorry. Please don't leave me. It's fine.
Okay, you know what? Let's just get this over with.
Because I'm pretty sure your family would rather be anywhere else than sitting here watching the show that we've already seen because we work here.
Wine.
Oh, crisp, fresh air, fun balloons, music, no agenda. A parade is a great way for everyone to celebrate a big day together, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah! Look, here comes one now.
Boo!
Boo?
Yeah, what are we supposed to cheer for, a giant corporate logo?
It's just a big, fun thing that kids like to look at.
I just used my iPhone to post on Facebook, corporations suck!
Ah. All right, well, here's one that's not corporate, it's just fun.
Boo!
Look at the bloodthirsty crowd celebrating the murder of millions of innocent turkeys by parading one through the streets.
Yeah, it kind of reminds me of Gaddafi on his way to his jury trial. Oh, right. Neither Gaddafi nor this turkey got a trial. They just got one in the brain, man.
Oh, good. Here comes the balloons that we put in the parade.
Okay, but what is it?
Well, can't you tell? It's a blanket coated in smallpox.
Oh, come on. That's not something I really want to explain to my kids on a holiday.
Oh, yeah? Well, then you're complicit, man, in covering up the murders.
I'm not covering up the... Good grief. Is that Gloria Steinem?
It's an 80-foot homage to the queen of feminism. Does that blow your mind as a man?
No, my wife's been the boss of me for 10 years. It's just not entertaining.
Oh, I see. Well, maybe you'd like it better if she was in blackface.
Okay, why is that always the first place you go?
It's bad enough that it's moving forward as an advancement is inherently patriarchal.
Okay, mm-hmm. Will you stop? You sound like my film professors.
Oh, here's our last float. Behold, the 2,000-page bill that became Obamacare.
Yay!
Obamacare! 2012!
Wow, it's enormous. That must use a lot of helium.
Maybe. Nobody really knows what's in it.
Whoops.
Wow. It just took out the Veterans Memorial Hospital.
Yeah, take that, veterans!
Look, it's the Pillsbury Doughboy!
No, that's Glenn Beck.
Boo!
How did that get in our parade?
Well, they probably pulled a few strings. It's a play on words.
Yeah, we got it.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, it looks so real.
Yeah.
Look at how crazy they made the eyes.
Oh, wait a second. That's no balloon. That's the real Glenn Beck.
Oh, no. He must have realized how much money he's burning through on GBTV. Here comes a teardrop! Okay, this parade is officially horrible.
Like Israel's treatment of Palestine?
Goodbye.
Hey guys, do you want to go to Brooklyn and spray paint some swastikas on cars?
Yeah!
All right, let's go!
Do it. Come on!
Pumpernickel Boulevard! Yeah!
Black Friday memories.
I had a wonderful dinner with the family, and I spent this great time with my kids. And I just remember wanting to get the hell out of there and stand in sub-zero temperatures outside of Walmart until midnight or more, you know?
Was it worth trampling another human being to death in order to save $80 on a plasma TV? You would say no. But then again, you paid full retail price for your television set, so who are you to judge me?
Black Friday is special to me because it's when Glenn Beck starts to release a new book every single day. It's like he's a publishing advent calendar. Instead of chocolate, you get delicious books. Oh, did you hear that? An angel didn't get their wings. No, he just published a new book.
Black Friday is really special to me because that's when the diamond commercials start airing. The ones where women imply that they'll have sex with their husbands in exchange for tennis bracelets. Now, while it makes women look horrible, it's also completely true. You should see what I did for earrings.
Black Friday memories.
Okay, let's try a Thanksgiving tradition that I know you'll all love. It's about fun animals and forgiveness. How does that sound?
That sounds great.
Yeah. That's awesome, man.
Let's pardon the Thanksgiving turkey.
No way, that's great.
On behalf of a grateful nation, I hereby pardon you, Mr. Turkey.
Brian, it's so kind of you to give Mr. Turkey a second chance.
Well, that is the spirit of Thanksgiving.
No, seriously, Brian.
Not many people in a position of power like you are willing to overlook a criminal's past and see the person within.
Well, he's not a criminal, he's a turkey.
Exactly, Brian. Mr. Turkey's quote, unquote, crimes are the symptom of societal sickness.
Sickness which I shall burn with a righteous fire, Brian Sack.
Oh, Mr. Turkey.
I'm sorry, he's really committed crimes?
Well, he was convicted of burning down churches all across the American Southwest.
The flames burnt the churches. It was only my job to call them forth.
I just pardoned an arsonist?
That's right, Dukakis.
He also put a screwdriver in the neck of a bank teller, allegedly.
No, I did that. Also, I was an assistant coach at Penn State, if you know what I mean.
It's heartbreaking when you're from the turkey enclosure like Mr. Turkey here. There's no opportunity, no chance to get up and out while playing by the man's rules.
He did what any of us would do.
Burn down churches?
He found God.
All right, well, that's fine.
By converting to Islam in prison.
Assalamu alaikum, gobble gobble. I can't wait to spread the word.
Okay, I clearly jumped the gun on pardoning the turkey.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a nun to go choke. Smell y'all later.
Should we stop him, you think?
That's profiling.
Okay. I don't know why I hang out here so much.
Pumpernickel Boulevard!
Hello, John.
Hello, Peter.
Have you invited the Indians to the Thanksgiving feast?
I'm sorry, the who?
The Indians.
The who?
The Indians.
The who?
The Native Americans.
Oh, heavens no.
You got tickets to the big concert? You're kidding me, how?
I got them from a scalper.
Hey.
Chief, would you like to play a game?
Sure.
It's called Cowboys and Indians.
How do you play?
You run around and we shoot you.
Oh, so it's a lot like the game of Settlers and Indians.
I guess so, yeah.
All right, we can, I guess. Pilgrim Fridays.
Welcome to Thanksgiving dinner, Brian.
Well, thanks for having me, Hoodie.
Hey, can I get you a glass of wine?
You know what? I could really use a glass of wine.
You got it. I'll be right back.
All right.
Hi, Brian. Happy Thanksgiving.
Hi there. Happy Thanksgiving to you, Sarah Bear.
Hope you're hungry.
You know what? I haven't eaten a thing all day. In fact, I would love if you would put me down for a turkey leg.
Oh, this is a cruelty-free Thanksgiving.
Oh.
Yeah, we snuck into McNichol's farm and emancipated all their turkeys last week.
Oh, that was you.
Here's your wine.
Oh, that's different.
Yeah, I know. You mean terrible. It's so hard to find a palatable, biodynamic, organic, sustainable fair trade wine that donates a portion of its proceeds to Africa.
Oh, surprising.
Ta-da! Tofurkey!
Yum!
Can I help you bring anything else from the kitchen?
Well, we couldn't find any cans of locally sourced cranberry, and there's no way I'm eating genetically modified corn.
Thank you.
Green beans?
They were out of organic.
Mashed potatoes?
I have potatoes.
Oh, great.
But my recycled bamboo potato masher warped in the dishwasher.
Mm. Right.
I'll go get some apple cider.
Okay.
Oh, and here's the stuffing.
Thank you. Did you use salt?
No, I'm trying to reduce my sodium footprint.
Butter?
Trans fats.
Chicken broth?
Are you kidding me? The price of free-range chicken broth has tripled.
Chestnuts?
You know, some people have nut allergies.
I don't.
Well, neither do I. But we should all pay the price.
So basically, this is a bowl of hot steaming bread.
Stuffing.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you know what? I'll go get some carbon neutral napkins. They're made from wishes.
Pumpernickel.
Every year, thousands of men and women are brutally maimed in one of the most dangerous places on Earth, our nation's shopping malls. I'm talking, of course, about the victims of Black Friday. Whether it was the Tickle Me Elbow Massacre of 1996, which alone left 700 people dead and over 12,000 injured, or JCPenney-geddon, in which pieces of bone are still being found in the Dockers section of the store, we all know someone who has been affected by Black Friday. This weekend, a percentage of each purchase you make at Walmart will be donated to the Theodore James Max Memorial Foundation for people trampled to death or injured by mobs of mindless feral holiday shoppers, the number three charitable organization for America's Black Friday veterans. These people need our help. Whether suffering from PTTS, post-traumatic trampling syndrome,
wow. Look at the discounts at Macy's.
Discounts. Discounts. Oh. Stop pushing me. Stop it. I need that too.
Or basic run-of-the-mill night terrors.
Oh man, they're everywhere. The Furbies. Oh, they're in the trees. The Furbies are on my skin.
Black Friday vets need your help. So don't spend time with your family this Thanksgiving. Get in line at 10 p.m. Thursday night to save a life.
Look out, Indian attack!
Where? Oh no!
You just fell for the newest trick in the book. Newest because we're here in olden times.
We cannot defeat you, white man. You have bested our people.
Well, you fought well, but we have superior technology.
But the Great Spirit, it sends me a vision that one day we will defeat you.
With your silly bows and arrows?
No, craps and blackjack. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
How?
How who?
No, how, hello.
Great. Pilgrim Fridays.
So, how was dinner?
Oh, I couldn't eat another thing. Is there any dessert?
Oh, yeah.
Great, because I'm starving.
Well, for dessert, we thought we'd serve knowledge. So we invited our friend Chris over to read to us about Thanksgiving.
I see. Does he live in the neighborhood?
Oh, well, Chris isn't a he, or she. Chris is gender neutral. Chris's parents, Aladdin and Luna, don't want to label Chris and burden Chris with a gender role.
Oh, hi, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Hi.
Go ahead and read your story, Chris.
What Thanksgiving Means to Me by Chris Stevenson - Edwards. Thanksgiving means dinner with my family. Thanksgiving means fun and talking. Mm-hmm. Thanksgiving means daddy eating a lot and getting tired. Thanksgiving means a pilgrim shattering the lives of the peaceful Indians, spreading their European disease and contempt for nature. Thanksgiving means celebrating the ruin of...
Who is feeding this stuff to him?
Chris is a Chris, not a he nor a she.
Mm-hmm.
I have a question, Chris. Do you sit down when you pee?
No.
You're a boy.
Pumpernickel Boulevard!
Yeah! Oh, boy. That was a lot of fun. And speaking of giving thanks, I just want to say I'm really grateful to work with people who are so wonderful and willing to take time off of a great holiday to come down and watch the show with me. It really means a lot that you're willing to do that.
Well, that's a heartwarming sentiment, Brian. If only it described the plane of reality in which we live.
I'm here because I thought you were pinned under a giant lemon, Brian. And I really wanted to see a giant lemon, darn it!
Can we go now, Brian?
You know, my wife just had a baby.
Oh, enough with
that. Wow, you're a baby.
Only everyone has ever done that.
Okay, you may go.
Right. About that baby for one more second.
And I promise, I'm never gonna lie to you to get you guys to come back to the studio ever again, all right? Scout's honor.
ABC's 1+1. Learning's great, learning's fun. Great times and diversity. We're all the same, you and me.
Yay!
Feeling good, having fun. Everybody's number one. Eating vegan, living green. We don't keep score, that would be mean. Pumpernickel Boulevard. Pumpernickel Boulevard. Pumpernickel Boulevard. Pumpernickel Boulevard.
You know, my wife just had a baby.